Hello, hello. This is Brother West. This is Brother West. I got one thing to I want to say to you in regards to the enemy, in regards to witchcraft, in regards to the tactics of the enemy, because the scripture said he comes as an angel of light. So in other words, he's going to come as an imitator. He's going to come appealing to a way where you think what he is will cause you to become relaxed. He's going to come in a way to make you think that he's godly or he has your best interest at heart. But he comes, he transforms, and he can transform a chameleon. The enemy can transform into anything. And one of the most dangerous persons who's wicked and have wicked intentions, a person who can fake anything. And that's basically the word that I want to speak to you, fake emotions. Fake emotions. The scripture says that we're not ignorant concerning Satan devices. One of the devices that the enemy uses that many are ignorant to is fake passion, fake emotion. He will, if you're a temperamental person, if you're a person who's given to anger, what he will do, you will have a head on collision with him. And what will happen, he will cause you to become angry, and it would appear that he's angry too. He'll use anger to become connected to you. So in other words, if you're a person who's given anger, you will meet someone. And then the person you meet, you might have a conversation or you might bump heads. And in you bumping heads, you fall out. But in the fallout, there is a shock. There's a connection. There's something similar. See, one of the things that the enemy does too, the enemy uses familiarity to draw you. So in other words, familiar things from your past, you know, things that you've done, things that you've been through, things that you've dealt with, things that you've been bound in. He will bring people similar pathway or a similar background as far as the same as you. And the purpose of it is to get you to listen, to draw you. And see what it is, hurt people hurt people. So in other words, if you look at a dog, you look at a cat, you look at a lion, tigers, bears, oh my, whatever they are, they all hang out with their own. They don't hang out with their own litter, naturally. So spiritually, emotionally, the same thing. People who are bitter, people who are going through some emotional situation. Also, people's hearts are carved a certain kind of way. All these things, there's going to come a connection. If you find that, you find yourself being connected to someone you don't know, but it seems like there's something that's drawing you because of a similar background, oftentimes that's true. See, the enemy knows that too. And so what he will do, he will cause you to connect with something or someone that's not good, that has the same similar background as you. And the purpose of it is to pull you and turn you away from who God is and the foundation of what God has put in you. And see, a distraction is also to distract you, to stop you from listening, to stop you from paying attention, stop your focus, stop you from really paying attention to what's happening, what you're viewing in front of you. And so that's what the enemy does. The enemy, he will try to distract you, meaning that traction with a car and tires, when tires are purchased, when they're first bought, those tires are full of tread. But what happens, what causes a distraction from those tires is when those tires have become worn. You've rode in them for a long time, for a while. Then what happens? Then there will come a spill, or it will rain outside. And then you go to stop. Something calls you to stop, to hit your brakes automatically. What will happen? You will slide. So in other words, you will break tread. And so, and see, when you break tread, that means that potentially you could have an accident because you won't stop on the dime. You won't stop in your tracks. And so the enemy is trying to stop you from stopping in your track, but he wants you to slide. He wants you to distract you. He wants you to get your focus off. He want to get your tread. He want to wear your tread down. And then once he can wear your tread down, he's going to try to shock you. Will you respond or react a certain way? And you react in a certain way. He wants you to. His plan is to get you to slide into something that's going to cause you to become destroyed or to cause you to sin. So those are some of my words that the enemy does. Some of my words that the enemy does when it comes to God's people. He's smart. He's crafty. He's sound in wisdom, perfect in beauty. And so just know the tactic that they use is fake emotion. And he's using emotions to connect. Using emotion to connect. Then once you connect, gotcha. If you entertain or you allow him to play with your emotion. See, because when there's something that happens out of the unusual, because your imagination is great, your imagination is always running, your mind is going to wonder. And in your mind wondering, he's going to fill your mind up. Those are my words.